Hello little friends, welcome back to online story time. As always, we start with a Shanti mantra. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayah, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kashchit Dukkha Bhag Bhavet. Hari Om Tat Sat. Swami Vivekananda founded two monasteries, one at Belur close to Calcutta, which became the headquarters of the Ramakrishna Math and Mission, and the other at Mayavati on the Himalayas called the Advaita Ashram. These monasteries train young men who would eventually become sannyasis of the Ramakrishna Math and Mission. Today, let us see why Vivekananda started them. Vivekananda wanted to have the relics of Sri Ramakrishna permanently housed in an enduring and imposing temple. He planned for the construction of the Belur Math on the banks of Ganga because during his lifetime Sri Ramakrishna stayed in Dakshineshwar on the bank of Ganga, and he loved to stay beside this great river. In the early part of 1898, Vivekananda purchased a large tract of land in Belur. There was a small building there already. His English disciple, Miss Muller, helped him financially to buy this property. You know, the purchasing of this particular site was the fulfillment of a prophecy by Vivekananda. Long before his going to the West, one day Vivekananda was standing on the Varanagar Ghat just opposite to this place along with his brother disciples. Vivekananda just told them, "Something tells me that our permanent mutt will be in this neighborhood across the river." At that time, there was no decision to buy a permanent area for Ramakrishna temple. There was no money at all. But Vivekananda could see the future. Or we can say that his words came true because he was so pure in heart. Till then, the grounds were used as a dockyard for country boats. So they were very hollow and uneven and had to be filled up and leveled. Besides, many repairs had to be done to the existing building and another floor had to be added. And a temple had to be constructed for Sri Ramakrishna. Vivekananda now had sufficient funds which he had received from his London disciples. Somewhat later, Vivekananda received a large sum of money from Mrs. Old Bull, which helped him to continue the construction work. I think you remember we discussed this point in our last story time. On 27 February 1898, on the auspicious occasion of Sri Ramakrishna's Tithi Puja, what is Tithi Puja? Birthday celebration according to Indian calendar. So Vivekananda on Sri Ramakrishna's Tithi Puja arranged a special puja of Sri Ramakrishna at the new site for the mutt. 12 years ago, Sri Ramakrishna had told Vivekananda, that time he was Naren. He told, "I will go and live wherever you take me, carrying me on your shoulder, be it under a tree or in a humble cottage." Keeping these words in mind, Vivekananda carried the relics of Sri Ramakrishna on his right shoulder and led the procession of monks and devotees to the new site. Vivekananda himself conducted the worship of the relics and lighted the homam fire. He then cooked payasam and offered it to Sri Ramakrishna. After finishing the puja, Vivekananda addressed the assembly. These are very famous words. Pray today, all of you, heart and soul, that the great avatara Sri Ramakrishna reside in this holy spot for a great length of time. Bahujana hitaya, bahujana sukhaya. For the welfare of many, for the happiness of many. And ever continue to make it a unique center of harmony amongst all religions. Vivekananda stayed here in a room facing the Ganga up to the end of his life. To the eastern side of the courtyard is a mango tree. Vivekananda was very fond of this tree, and under this tree he used to conduct classes and meet his brother monks and disciples and also play with some pet. This mango tree is much more than 100 years old now. If you go to Belur Math, you will see Vivekananda's room and the mango tree and, of course, the grand temple of Sri Ramakrishna and a few more beautiful temples in the huge complex. The design of Ramakrishna temple was envisioned by Vivekananda himself. The unique design celebrates the diversity of all religions because Sri Ramakrishna supported all religious paths as valid and said, Jato mot toto path, meaning as many religions, that many paths to God. Visitors from all over the world come here to see this architectural wonder. And they start to pray as this is a land of serene spirituality. We can say that the Belur Math temple is the architectural manifestation of Vivekananda's dream of having a permanent abode for his master Sri Ramakrishna. Here I'll tell you that though the property was purchased at the beginning of 1898, it became the permanent headquarters of the monks from January 1899 after most of the construction work was over. Sri Ramakrishna's temple was inaugurated much later though, much after Vivekananda passed away. With the help of his English disciples, Mr. and Mrs. Sevier, Vivekananda started Advaita Ashram in the Mayavati in the Himalayas. While visiting the Alps in Europe with them, Vivekananda for the first time told them about this longing he had to establish a monastery in the heart of his beloved Himalayas. He said, "Where I can retire from the labors of my life and pass the rest of my days in meditation. It will be a center for work and meditation where my Indian and Western disciples can live together." All these things Vivekananda said while in Alps. Mr. Sevier said immediately, "How nice it would be, Swamiji, if this could be done. We must have such a monastery." He was determined. At that time, it was only a passing remark, but as the months went by, that stray remark made in the heights of the Alps was seen to have been prophetic. The idea sunk deep into the hearts of those disciples, Mr. and Mrs. Sevier, and Vivekananda's great desire was fulfilled through their practical help and cooperation. A place in the Himalayas was to be found out which will be suitable for practicing the Advaita philosophy. Vivekananda had written to a friend that this monastery must be about 7,000 feet above sea level. See, he did not want to kill his Western disciples who would come to work in India for helping in his cause by forcing them the Indian primitive way of living in the fiery heat of the plain lands. So So that was another reason for opening a center in the cool Himalayas. On his tours through the Himalayas, he had himself looked for a suitable site in the hills in and about Dharamsala, Mori, Srinagar, Dehradun, even the town of Almora, but none answered the purpose satisfactorily. Later, he left the matter in the hands of Mr. and Mrs. Sevier. This couple and Vivekananda's disciple Swami Swarupananda made an extensive tour into the interiors of the Almora mountains. And in the course of an extensive search, they came upon the beautiful estate of Mayavati. It was a thickly wooded hill at an elevation of 6,300 feet and 50 miles from Almora town. It commanded a magnificent view of the snow ranges. It still does. They decided it at once to be the spot for their cherished scheme of starting the Advaita Ashrama. The purchase was promptly made and they came to make it their retreat on March 19, 1899, which happened to be the auspicious birth anniversary of Sri Ramakrishna. So you see, by providence, both the main ashramas were started on Ramakrishna Tithi Puja Day. The Advaita Ashram in the Mayavati is meant for following Sri Ramakrishna's teaching of non-dualism of God. Here there is no external worship of images, pictures or symbols of God, nor any religious ceremony or ritual except the Viraja Homa. Viraja Homa is done when the monks become monk. The sannyasi diksha, when they get it, that homa is known as Viraja Homa. So only that is allowed there. Here, even Sri Ramakrishna is not worshipped. Worship of Sri Ramakrishna is the central feature in all the other mud centers, you see. The Advaita Ashram was founded with the heartfelt blessings of Vivekananda. It is not much to say that the Advaita Ashram is the most unique of all the institutions started under the inspiration of Swami Vivekananda. Let's do a small chant. Om Bhur Bhuvasuva Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Na Prachodayat Om.